Continuing now with our top story, Iraq and the presidential campaign. Joining us from Washington, one of the most astute analysts on Iraq, Lieutenant Colonel Ralph Peters, has visited there three times and is the author of the brand new book, Looking for Trouble, Adventures in a Broken World. All right, Colonel, you just heard my conversation with Mark Lamont Hill. You got any comment on it?
Yeah, it was interesting to hear him tap dance on that one. You know, I think that Barack Obama, like so many men throughout history, Bill, has found that the withdrawal method just doesn't work for him. Seriously, I'm sorry that the hard right's jumping on Obama on this and calling him a flip-flopper. We should really be encouraging him. This is good news for the country and for our military, for Iraq, that Obama's starting to show some political savvy, if not outright understanding of the Iraq situation. I mean, he clearly recognizes that things are going so much better, it can't be denied, and he doesn't want to be on the blame line as a guy who lost Iraq. So instead of saying, oh, gotcha, flip-flopper, I'd say, hey, welcome to the reality club, Senator Obama.
Okay, but for the record, this program has not said that Obama is a flip-flopper, and we understand
the complexity. No, Bill, you have not.
No, but we understand the complexity of the issue.
Yeah.
But I think it's all about Petraeus now. See, Petraeus now has emerged to those of us who follow, and I'm sure you too, as a true American military hero, the modern-day U.S. Grant, who took a situation that was untenable, that Barack Obama said would never, the surge would never work, and all the Democrats, you heard that, never worked, never worked, never worked, turned it around and it has worked. So now Obama goes over to see the general, all right? And the general looks him in the eye, and Obama can't come back and say, I'm not taking his advice. You can't do that. That's suicide. He'd never win the election. Am I wrong?
No, I think you're absolutely right on that. And General Petraeus is a remarkable man who's had just stunning achievements. Of course, there are a lot of other people, soldiers, Marines, sailors, airmen, that are involved in this too.
Oh, absolutely.
But clearly, Petraeus is a great man, and great men matter. He rose to the occasion.
He did.
Did a marvelous job, and now the Democrats are faced with the amazing disappearing war. Casualties are lower in Iraq than they are in Afghanistan.
But there's still, as you heard Dr. Hill say, the unjust war mantra.
Yeah.
And that is on the far left. Look, if you go into the far left websites tonight, you will see Barack Obama getting hammered by the very people who made it possible for him to win the primaries. Okay? They believe that we are the oppressor in Iraq, that we're morally wrong for being there. How can you convince them they're wrong? Can you, Colonel?
Yeah, no, you cannot. You cannot. Their lives are so invested in their vision of America, the evil empire, that you'll never move them along. And they can't move. It means jettisoning their whole lives. So we have to deal with all the rest of the American people who do have a sense of reality, who do support the troops, whether they were for going into Iraq or not. And I remember, you know, left-wingers were in the 90s, were writing about the genocide of the Kurds, the Shias, you know, the first Bush let them down. And had Bill Clinton invaded Iraq, he'd be celebrated as the new Lincoln. I mean, this is so politicized, it's sad, it's bad for our country. And that goes back to why I'm glad that Barack Obama is starting to say, oh, wait, not so fast, big boy, because I want what's good for our country. I'm not a party animal.
Yeah, I mean,
and really,
me
when
too.
I look at Iraq, I know you are too, Bill, and when I look at Iraq, the change is astonishing. It's hard to find the war. I mean, al-Maliki making his remark about he wants a timetable purely for domestic Iraqi consumption.
Yeah, absolutely. That's purely to show the Iraqis that he's a tough guy. Real one quick question, I want one on the book. Is there any chance of a reversal? Could this thing then go south? Because we're very optimistic now that the United States is going to win the situation. Could it just turn, you know, for the worse?
Well, Bill, I never underestimate the Arab genius for failure. But that said, it would take a lot to reverse it at this point.
Okay.
One thing that would reverse it is a quick withdrawal.
Your book, Looking for Trouble. You don't look like a troublemaker, Colonel, but I think you are. Why should people buy this book?
Well, people should buy it because it's a damn fun read. I mean, this book is enjoyable, but the themes are serious. But it tells you, the reader, about how we got where we are today. I was very privileged in the Army. I mean, I really got the fun travel and adventure part. The Army sent me in the 90s as a troubleshooter in the 80s, from the dying Soviet Union to the Caucasus to Burma, drug wars in South America, downtown L.A., Pakistan, and I got to see how the terrorists were formed. how the new Russia was formed, how we got there. And I wasn't alone. I'd be out there with maybe one other guy, two other guys, or sometimes alone. And we'd come back to Washington and say, hey, the terrorists are coming. Hey, the thugs are coming.
So it's the origin of where we are now. It's how we got to
right.
where we are now in the war on terror. All right, Colonel, I'm looking forward to reading it. Looking for Trouble, Adventures in a Broken World. We always appreciate talking with you.